Hello, hello, mic test. Okay, that is awesome, right? CAGR is more than 100%. It's 113.48%. Maximum drawdown is very small, only 7.25%. Win rate is close to 60%. Profit factor is amazing, which is 3.26. Yeah, this is great, guys. We actually transformed our inside bar trading strategy to something really amazing, thanks to the three-layered backtesting of Tradomate.one. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you are here to blow your mind with a great trading strategy, then you are at the right place. In this video, I will use an example strategy at Tradomate.one called insider bar trading strategy, and then eventually keep improving it with the three-layered backtesting tool. This is the entire playlist on Tradomate.one. I made multiple videos of different trading strategies like MACD, Momentum, RSI plus Doji. The last video was on EMA crossover, but it was a great trading strategy, and this one is on inside bar trading strategy. If you're new to my YouTube channel, guys, on this channel I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to making trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, using some highly valuable finance APIs, and making some great trading strategies. So if this is something that you're interested in, then click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are many more videos that are coming on this YouTube channel, and I bet you that watching the videos on this channel will improve your skill sets significantly. Before starting, guys, a quick disclaimer. Through this video, neither me nor Tradomate.one is recommending any trading strategy or investment strategy. This is an educational video. This video is focused on teaching you how to use Tradomate.one platform and not to recommend any strategy or stock. So yes, please do your detailed research before putting your real money into it. So yes, this is the platform, which is Tradomate.one. The link is in the description section. If you have not yet signed up, guys, you can start for free. Just click on this button and sign up with your email address or directly through Google, right? So if you click this one, for me it directly opens the dashboard because I've already signed up in this platform. These are some of the trading strategies that I built in the past, so that's why I can see it on the dashboard. On the left hand side you can see builder, where we'll be building our trading strategy. Docs is a place where you will have the detailed documentation of how to use the platform, right? You can see like orders, how to extract the information, etc., etc. And then Discord server, a very important thing, guys. We also have a very active Discord community. We call it Tradomate Army, where there are many already traders who are like doing detailed in-depth discussion with each other and with the Tradomate team. So yeah, it's free of cost, guys. I highly insist you to check it out. Great, so let's start with creating new bot. Clicking on this button, Python bot creator, let's proceed. Okay, so this is the list of all the already existing example strategies in this platform. I'll just click on inside bar strategy because this is something that we want in this video. Let's click on proceed. Perfect. So we have in the past we have used Infosys, TCS, HDFC. In the last video I made the trading strategy on Axis Bank. Let's do it on, say, SBI, which is State Bank of India. Perfect. So on the top you can see the candlesticks chart of SBI. This is the ticker, exchange, and the currency, which is Indian rupee. This is a place where you can actually select the time interval of the candlestick. So suppose if I do 30, it will refresh and make a 30 minutes candlesticks graph like this. On the bottom you will see this code, which is basically the code of this trading strategy. The first function is used to provide your trading inputs, strategy inputs, and the second function is where you build your own trading logics, right? So for example, in the inputs we have initial capital and quantity. In this particular area we have the entire logic. So let's keep everything exactly the same right now, and just let's make quantity to be 10, because the current price is somewhere around 800. We have 50,000 initial capital. So we should be increasing some quantity. Let's click on save and run. Perfect. On the chart, we can see all the places where we have placed the orders. If we extend this particular thing, this is the first layer of three-layered backtesting tool that we have. Why we call it three-layered backtesting? Because we split it into three different parts to make it easy to understand. The first layer has net profit, CAGR, maximum drawdown, etc. In this case, we have a CAGR of say around 8%, which is not very good, but it's okay. This is the first iteration. We'll keep on working on it. Maximum drawdown is something which is quite impressive, which is only 2.35%. Win rate is decent, close to 50% only. Profit factor and number of trades are also decent. Let's move to the second layer of backtesting, clicking on the proceed to next step button and proceed. Okay, so this is the equity curve of SBI. We actually did pretty good in the beginning and then we had a significant downfall. I think this is the time when we had election results in India. That's why a huge volatility at this time. Then eventually again went to the same direction only. The volatility has been quite low only, except this particular area, which is again suggested by the standard deviation also, only 4.4%. Let's click on this particular button, which is view all. Sharpe ratio is 1.35. Pretty good. Beta is quite low, 0.28 only. Gross profit is 14.9 and gross loss is 9.52%. We can actually take a bit more risk definitely by looking at these numbers. I'll definitely increase the number of quantity. Let's click on orders. Here you can see that there are some of the places where we actually lost a lot of money, somewhere around 3% loss. This is decent, more than 3% and so on, right? And some great profits as well, like 7% profit. So in order to make it more consistent, I will definitely introduce stop loss and take profit. So I'll click on edit strategy, extend it a bit. So yeah, these are the inputs, initial capital, quantity. I have two more inputs now, which is SLPCT, which is stop loss percent and take profit percent. Let's keep it 1.5 and 4.5% only, as we did in the last video as well. Risk reward ratio is 1:3. Here I'll have to provide stop loss percent is equal to this thing. I'll just directly copy and paste, and same with the take profit percent is equal to config.tppct. Just copy this entire thing. I'll do the same thing in the short position as well. Let's increase the quantity to 20 and save and run. Perfect. Now this looks much better. CAGR is close to 20%. Maximum drawdown is again very small. Win rate is decent only, again 50% only. Profit factor is 1.54. So we are, by looking at this, we can say that we are making some big profits. That's why the profit factor is pretty high and the win ratio is not that great. That's fine. Let's do one thing. I will go to the third layer of analysis, which is this one. And over here, I'll just click on the scenario analysis button here. Let's click on market trend and test the scenario. Perfect. So what happens in this particular analysis is we split the entire segment into bullish, bearish or sideways market trend. And we just want to see what happens in only bullish time, what happens in only bearish time and what happens only in the sideways market. And that's how we, I would say, tweak our trading strategies if the strategy is only working for a particular market trend, right? So in this case, you can see the green line is on the top, right? The red line here and the yellow line is here. So it means that we are doing pretty good in the bullish time and not that great in the sideways market. You can see it here as well. The CAGR of bullish time is 9.29%, of bearish time is 6.16% and sideways is 1.03. Like I would say it's not that bad because still we are making some money in the sideways market, because in most of the cases it's negative in sideways if we are following a trend specific trading strategy. So the profit factor is pretty good in all of them. The best part here is the number of trades in bullish time is the highest, which is 104. So we can actually do a lot of things to improve this particular segment because we are making the highest profit in the bullish time as well. In the bearish time it's decent, and in the sideways market we are taking 25 trades, which we can actually eliminate some of them to make it better, right? So again, not a lot of changes to be done here. I'll just click on edit strategy. I'll just provide one more filter of ADX. But before that, let's do one thing. There's a lot of noise here, so I'll just delete these comments, right? And let's do one more thing here. So there are a couple of conditions here. The condition one is equal to this one, which is common in both buying and selling. So that's condition one. So I'll just replace this with condition one. Same goes with the buy condition, which is this one, and sell condition is this one. Let me just replace this with buy condition and this one with sell condition. Now this looks quite tidy now. So what else? We had to provide ADX. So ADX is equal to tm.ta.adx. What do we need? Data.high, data.low, data.close, and the last one is time period, which is, let's stick to the same, which is 14, right? I will add this condition in the condition one only. Just write and ADX dot I lock last value, which is -1, should be greater than, I'll do 30. Why strict? Because we already are making a lot of trades. It's absolutely fine if we reduce some of the trades here. So let's keep 30 as of now, and I will increase this to higher quantity because we are making good profit. Let's do it 70. Let's see if this makes sense. What else? I think that's it. In the end, I will plot ADX. Title is equal to ADX. Color is equal to red. And overlay is equal to false. I don't want it to be on the same graph. I want a separate graph for ADX. Let's click on save and run. Okay, that is awesome, right? CAGR is more than 100%. It's 113.48%. Maximum drawdown is very small, only 7.25%. Win rate is close to 60%. Profit factor is amazing, which is 3.26. Yeah, this is great, guys. We actually transformed our inside bar trading strategy to something really amazing thanks to the three-layered backtesting of Tradomate.one. Okay guys, so yeah, that's it. There can be more things that we can do in this particular code. I keep it on you. If you get better results, please let me know in the comment section. But yeah guys, if you like even one thing about this video, please click on the like button because it really helps with the YouTube algorithm. And also, there are many more videos coming on this channel which will help you improve your trading experience a lot. So please click on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon to stay tuned to my YouTube channel. There will be a few more videos coming on the same platform, which is Tradomate.one. Please let me know if you have any feedback, any specific topics to cover. Let me know in the comment section. If you get many likes, then I promise that I will cover it in the next videos. Lastly, guys, check out the Discord community, which is Tradomate Army Discord server. I don't want you guys to miss out on the great conversation that is happening on that community. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you'll see this entire playlist on Tradomate.one. Over there you'll see this walkthrough video on Tradomate.one. Keep learning, keep financial programming, and I'll see you very soon in the next video next Saturday. Until then, peace.